Nissan's luxury division has been struggling to keep up with the competition for almost a decade, and we think that the primary reason was the fact that the brand was unable to come up with something really impressive, something that would blow our minds. It looked like the lack of inspiration was the main reason for the brand's decline, but now it's time to get back on track, because the new 2024 Infiniti QX Monograph is here, and we see it as a pretty bold statement that this is the most spectacular vehicle this Japanese luxury car maker has ever shown. Let's take a closer look. This isn't the first time we've encountered the Monograph nameplate. Infiniti already used it a couple of times for its concepts, and we were always pretty impressed, particularly with the QX80 Monograph, which previewed the new updated version of the brand's flagship model, the full-size SUV QX80. The design of that model was amazing, futuristic, and production-ready, which was proved soon after when the refreshed version was introduced. That design kept the already old and outdated SUV relevant for some more time, but even then, everyone was aware that the full-size SUV would have to get a full redesign in the near future to remain competitive in this demanding segment. And once again, the Japanese bring up the Monograph nameplate, this time with even more spectacular styling. Infiniti is one of those companies that know how to design an elegant car. So before the presentation, we all knew that the new concept would focus primarily on aesthetics rather than showing some advanced technologies. We expected to see something stylish, but this exceeded anyone's expectations. It doesn't take more than a quick look to realize that the concept is heavily based on the ongoing generation of the QX80. But the stylistic approach is simply out of this world, with a level of elegance we haven't seen in a long time. And what's particularly impressive is that, even though the company says this is just a study, the concept looks incredibly production-ready. And for that reason, we hope that Infiniti engineers won't change the production version much, and that this gorgeous piece of art will hit the road in pretty much unchanged form. Despite this simplistic, elegant design approach, with clean lines and sleek nature, there is so much going on, starting from the front-end design. There, the first thing you'll notice is that digital piano key lighting that spreads across the whole front side and sits above the all-new grille design, with a pattern we've never seen before. A pattern that's in perfect symbiosis with the new 3D logo, also presented for the first time. Moving to the side of the SUV, the same story continues. It's all about sleekness and elegance, which isn't a surprise if we consider that the three key principles Infiniti designers held on to were ma, the mastery of empty space, utsuroi, representing seamless transitions, and kabuku, which translates to provocative and extraordinary. With such a design approach, designers managed to transform this once boxy SUV into something that even exceeds the level of smoothness we can find in the latest Range Rover models. But clean design and smooth lines are just part of the story. It's also about details, starting from shaved door handles that complement this new styling form perfectly. Although more sophisticated, the new form of the QX doesn't lose muscles. Just look at those massive hips that are accentuated by a line that starts with the high hoods and continues all the way to the rear end. Of course, it would be hard to imagine such an elegant and futuristic design without proper paint, and once again, we can only applaud Infiniti designers, because that color, named Akane, is really something special. You don't see a finish with so many different layers every day, with the ability to reflect so many different nuances depending on the type and amount of light it's exposed to. That gorgeous color gets contrasted by some really subtle red accents, which can be noticed in some pretty untypical areas. For example, the windows are actually slightly red-tinted, while the real stars of the show are the wheels. They are massive and sculpted in a way that allows designers to combine various nuances on the spokes, starting from gloss black and shadow chrome, and ending with attractive red accents. We can't wait to see these wheels spinning. Finally, there's the rear-end design, characterized by a pretty simplistic design approach. The upright tailgate ensures the level of ruggedness you would expect from a classic body-on-frame SUV, while the biggest highlight of this part of the vehicle is definitely that massive bar that incorporates all lighting groups, once again in a digital keyboard manner, with a bit of 3D effect that perfectly complements the brand's well-known logo. With the QX in its moniker, It's quite obvious that this concept previews the next generation QX80, the company's flagship SUV. And as we mentioned, although incredible, this styling looks very production ready, so we expect minor changes only in the production version. But, as we also mentioned, this presentation put focus on aesthetics, so there are many other aspects to be clarified. The first thing that comes to mind is the platform. It's no secret that the concept was built over the ongoing model, but we are pretty sure that, unlike the previous time the Monograph concept previewed changes, this time visual changes won't be enough to keep this otherwise old and outdated design competitive. This SUV needs big updates to keep pace with rivals. And that doesn't surprise if we consider that other than styling changes, this generation has remained pretty much the same since the initial launch in 2010. The good old F-Alpha platform definitely needs updates, starting from the chassis reinforcement and new suspension to provide the desired ride quality. Nothing less important is the ability to accommodate new technologies, whether it's about new powertrain options or advanced driver assistance systems. Finally, let's talk about the interior design for a moment. The current generation doesn't impress in this aspect. Moreover, it lags behind the competition a lot, and that, of course, has to do with the model's age. All rivals are much younger, so Infiniti will have to put a lot of effort into bringing up a cabin design it can stand out with. New materials, the latest tech goodies, and the overall feel of quality need to be at a much higher level. On the other hand, we don't expect to see significant changes in terms of the overall cabin layout. The overall size shouldn't change much, so interior dimensions, and therefore seating configurations, are likely to remain the same or very similar. Of course, we might see some improvements in terms of passenger space, but only marginal. The same thing is with the cargo area, although a few more cubic feet would be nice. All these updates won't mean much without a proper powertrain upgrade. The next generation QX can't be successful without an engine that's not just powerful, but also efficient. With last year's redesign of the Lexus LX, the Infiniti's full-size SUV remains one of the rare models that still rely on a naturally aspirated V8 engine. With 400 horsepower and 413 pound-feet of torque, the current 5.6-liter V8 seems capable enough, but it is also one of the thirstiest engines around. Rivals predominantly use six-cylinder units with a turbocharger, and besides better fuel efficiency, also offer more torque. That's why we think that Infiniti needs to go in the same direction. The only problem is that Nissan doesn't exactly have a prepared replacement. Some speculate about the good old 3-liter twin turbo, but that engine simply doesn't deliver enough torque for a vehicle of this size and weight. So, one of the solutions could be a turbocharged version of the Frontier's 3.8-liter V6. But that also takes time to be developed. Finally, there is the matter of electrification. Like many other car makers, Infiniti is also likely to skip hybrids and go for full electrification instead. So, why wouldn't the current QX80 remain in production for a few more years until we see an all-electric QX with this gorgeous styling? We are just thinking out loud. The only problem with such a scenario is that the launch date would have to be prolonged, while the price would probably be six digits, considering that the current pretty outdated model already costs nearly $80,000. What do you think about the 2024 Infiniti QX Monograph? Let us know in the comments section, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.